Now we are going to see about discuss about unit 3, organic reactions and mechanism. This is for first year biotechnology students. So in our syllabus we have four types of reactions are there, and some mechanisms are available in our syllabus. First we are going to discuss about types of reactions. There are several types of reactions. One, addition reactions, elimination, substitution and rearrangement. So these four types of reactions are in our syllabus. First is addition reaction is carried out only in the unsaturated compound, that is double bonded compound. When the double bonded the unsaturated compound it formed into saturated compound is called addition reaction. Whenever a group is bind to unsaturated compound, the product will be like this. Next is elimination reaction. Elimination reaction is exactly opposite to addition reaction. The saturated compound is formed into unsaturated compound by eliminating some groups. YZ is called elimination reaction. This is saturated compound having YZ is group, some functional group which is eliminated, and the final product will be unsaturated compound. That is the compounds having double bond. Next is a substitution reaction. Substitution reaction, simply substituting a molecule into a reactant is called substitution reaction. Here the Z is substituted into this place and the final product will be like this, and the Y is left. The last one is rearrangement type. Rearrangement, so without altering any atoms, the groups are simply interchanged. It's called rearrangement. Here the R and X are interchanged each other. So these are four types of reactions are in our syllabus. So I am giving only the reaction pattern and the layouts. I am not giving any examples here. So these are in our syllabus. In continuation of this topic, we are going to see about nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. In this reaction, there is two types of reactions are available in our syllabus. One is SN2 reaction, which means substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. So S stands for substitution, N for nucleophilic, and 2 for bimolecular reaction. This is called SN2 reaction. I am giving the simple example. The methyl bromide is converted into methyl alcohol. Then the OH group, alcohol group, is attacked in backside to a methyl bromide. It transforms into transient state, and finally the product will be methyl alcohol. So during the course of reaction, the configuration of carbon atom is inverted and it's called Walden inversion. So let me compare with a classical example of an umbrella. Walden inversion of umbrella is like that. It's like in the air blows on the bottom side of umbrella, it seems to be Walden inversion. Now this is an umbrella and the Walden inversion of this umbrella. This is a classical example. Actually this umbrella is wrong. I am giving a new umbrella. Now this is the correct form of umbrella. You can compare the structure of umbrella to this structure of compound. You can see it is similar to the umbrella structure. The compound structure is similar to umbrella. So this is a classical example of SN2 reaction. Next, this is a potential energy diagram. R is reactant and P is product, and this is transition state. So the rate of the reaction is depends on the concentration of substrate and the nucleophile. It is second order reaction. So therefore the reaction is bimolecular, and the substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. The important keywords of this reaction is the reaction proceeds through and the reaction is carried out by backside attack of a functional group nucleophile. And the final product will be an Walden inversion. This reaction is carried out, proceeds through a transient state, and the entire reaction is a single step process. Okay, and you know well about the nucleophile is a negative charge, electrophile is positive charge, and free radical is free electron. So I'm not giving the I'm not touch up the basic aspects. So next is SN1 reaction. It stands for substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction. Substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction, SN1 reaction. This reaction proceeds by two step. It is a two step process. The step one is, here I am giving the example of tertiary butyl bromide to converted into tertiary butyl alcohol. So the step one is the alkyl halide ionizes and to give the carbonium ion. So the first step is the tertiary butyl bromide is given the carbonium ion. Actually this is the rate determining step. So next step is the OH group alcohol is attacked to the carbonium ion and the final product will be tertiary butyl alcohol. This is SN1 reaction. So the rate of the reaction is depends only the substrate, and it's a for a single step it's a two step reaction. The rate of the reaction is depends only the substrate. So the it's a unimolecular reaction. It has two transition state. So this is a potential energy diagram. So next is in our syllabus we have important organic reactions are there. We are going to see one by one. So one is esterification, hydrolysis of ester, condensation reaction, and Claisen rearrangement. First we are going to see about esterification. So the formation of ester from carboxylic acid and alcohol with an acid catalyst. This is called esterification. Here the carboxylic acid reacted with alcohol with an acid catalyst. The final product will be ester. So the formation of ester is esterification. Next is hydrolysis of ester. Is exactly reverse of esterification. Here the formation of carboxylic acid from the ester. So the ester is transformed into carboxylic acid. This is called hydrolysis of ester. And the third one is condensation reaction. So I am giving the example of Claisen condensation here. So two ethyl acetate is reacted together and form ethyl acetoacetate, and the ethanol is left. So actually condensation reaction is if the two molecules are combined together and form a new product, simultaneous removal of water or ethanol. I am giving the ethanol as example here. So two ethyl acetate are combined together, reacted together, and the product will be ethyl acetoacetate, and the ethanol is simultaneously ethanol will be removed. So this is called condensation reaction. I am giving the example of Claisen condensation. The next is Claisen rearrangement. I am not giving example here. So the allyl vinyl ether is converted into unsaturated carbonyl compound. So Claisen condensation and Claisen rearrangement is exactly it's different. Condensation is formation of ethyl acetoacetate, and the Claisen rearrangement is formation of unsaturated carbonyl compound. So these are the overall with this unit will be over. I am giving the totally layout of the keywords of this unit. So we will be seeing in the next class.